Okay, so any other thoughts when you saw that I said subtract 5x? Do you have like any opinions about that?
Oh, I have.
Yeah.
I was like, I'm probably just gonna take 2x minus 5x because of both x's.
Okay. 2x minus 5x.
And then the 3x is minus 5. On the other side. You gotta do both sides.
Not really an opinion.
That's it.
What you did.
Oh.
I didn't really.
You what?
I just solved that and then at the end.
So when you went to solve it, did you subtract 5x from both sides at any time?
No, not until I subtract 9 from each side and then.
Or did you subtract 5x?
No.
You subtracted stuff, but not 5x. Right? Did you ever subtract 5x?
Yeah.
Show me the step where you subtract 5x.
Well, I didn't. I erased it.
There's no 5x in there anywhere. You got 3x's, you got 2x's. But no 5x.
5x minus 3x.
Yeah.
I got 2x.
Come on, Austin.
Maybe 2.
James. Well, here's the thing. My other class had a reaction to it. Somebody said, like, why are we subtracting 5x? Anybody else wonder why would you subtract 5x? As opposed to what else would you do instead of subtracting 5x?
Minus 2.
Well, the only thing I noticed is that 2x and 3x take 5x.
Done. So in trying to make sense of it, you're like, well, 2x and 3x are 5x.
That's not what I
that's not what you did. What did you do to solve if you did solve?
Oh, I just subtracted them from both sides.
What from both sides?
I subtracted 5x from 2x and 5x from 2x.
But in wondering why I would have you subtract 5x, why is it a strange thing to subtract 5x from both sides? Brandon?
There's not 5x in a problem.
There's not a 5x, and in solving these, we would like, when we subtract some x's from one side, for what to happen? To get rid of some x's altogether, not just to randomly subtract the number of x's, okay? I'm bringing this up because in looking looking at period 4, now just flipping through yours, I'm seeing some things get tried. You're trying to do some things that I'm like, why are you doing that, okay? I'm trying to put you in my shoes here. Why would you do that? Why would you subtract 5x? I want you to have that feeling, because it doesn't really get us anywhere, all right? And some of the things you guys are trying to do, they don't really get you anywhere, right? You may do it correctly, but it just doesn't get you anywhere. And even worse, you may just do something completely false, okay? So I'm going to help you not do that. So in looking at your reviews, your homework reviews, I saw, like, we could definitely use some more practice. So we're going to get some more practice. I'm going to have you turn that 1.3 tomorrow. If you already turned it in, then fine. You'll have more time. If you didn't, you can turn this in tomorrow, okay? We're also going to have a few problems from 1.4. All right. So let's do this thing. If I subtract 5x from both sides, it would look like this, right? 2x plus 9 minus 5x equals 3x. I'm just writing it horizontally rather than vertically. I've subtracted 5x from both sides, have I not?
Yes, you did.
I guess you did.
Minus 5x. Not, probably not what anybody's work looks like, right?
No.
I'm just showing you horizontally. If I subtract 5x from the left side, can I combine the 2x and the negative 5x?
Yes.
Yes, I can. What does that make?
Negative
3x plus 9. 3x minus 7, can't put those together. But I can put negative 5 plus 3x.
Negative 2.
Negative
2x
minus 7.
Well, that's the same as your eventually.
What's that?
Mine looks the same as yours now. You didn't, but then it did.
Well, it looks kind of nutty. It looks weird. And it does not get us any closer. We really didn't make any progress in solving for x, right? What I want you to see is that some of what you guys are doing, you think it's helping you out, but you're actually making no progress. Probably because the thing you're trying to do, you're doing incorrectly, like mathematically incorrectly. And if you were to do it correctly, it wouldn't get you any closer. Okay, let me show you what I mean. If I have something like this equation, 2x plus 9 equals 3x minus 7, Try and divide by 2 on both sides.
Okay.
Divide by 2 on both sides.
You know, like you said, 0.6. It's confusing.
Divide by 2 on both sides. Just divide by 2 on both sides. Everybody in your own notes, divide by 2 on both sides. 2 on both sides. To start with, let's talk about why someone would think it might be a good idea to divide by 2. Why would someone divide by 2?
To get x by itself.
Okay, they're hoping to get x by itself. They see a 2x, and they've said countless times, I've seen a 2x, and I have divided it by 2. Because 2x divided by 2 is what?
1x.
And that is good. 1x, that's what I want. But in this equation, it's one of those things where you think it's getting you further down the road, you're making progress. It turns out, if you were to do it correctly, it would still be okay, it would still be true. We could still use that new equation to solve for x, but it's a mess. It's a big, big mess. Okay? The thing that we need to remember is that we can do whatever we want as long as we do it to what? Both sides. We have to do it to both sides. The key word there being sides. Both sides. Not then divide by 2 a little bit, right? Just divide by 2 a little bit on some of the part of the side, right? The whole side. The whole thing. All of it. This whole side has to get divided by 2. Okay? If I were to divide this by 2, I would have to divide the 2x by 2 and get x, and then divide the 9 by 2. Get 9 halves. And on this side, when I divide by 2, I would get 3 halves x minus 7 halves. Not wrong. Still correct. Still mathematically correct and true and all that kind of stuff. But do you feel like we've made progress by dividing by 2? Maybe sort of on just this part, just this term. But it made all three of the other terms more complicated to look at. Of a mess. Now, if you did divide by 2, it might look better to you, but you did it incorrectly, probably. Mm-hmm. So, not divide by 2. That is not something I would recommend. Let's talk about what would make some progress, okay? In each step, if your new equation looks a little simpler, then you're probably making progress and probably should keep going down that road. Okay? So what is somebody did to make some progress in solving for x? Mac?
Never mind.
Brandon?
I just did the 5 again.
I just did the 5 again?
The 5
again. 5x. But remember, when we subtract the 5x, it looks kind of the same as what we started with. Almost the same. Not really much simpler at all. Okay?
What did you do? Minus 2?
Minus 2.
Negative 2.
Or minus 2.
Oh, there.
Well,
minus 9. Minus 9.
Minus 9, okay. We can do whatever we want. The reason I put the minus 9 here is because if I'm going to subtract 9 from the left side, then the constant 9 is what I get subtracted from. Subtract 9 is subtracting 9 ones. I can only subtract ones from ones, not from x's, so I can't subtract 2 from 2x. And I can't subtract 9 from 2x, but I can subtract 9 from 9. What's 9 minus 9?
0.
0. We get 2x equals 3x negative 7 minus 9.
Negative 16.
Does it look like we've made some progress?
Yeah.
Sure.
Yeah.
How would you? Why would you say that we've made some progress? What is it about it?
It looks a little simple, Hunter.
Okay, we had 4 terms to start with. Now we only have 3. On the left side, we don't have a variable and a number. We just have a variable, just 2x. So it feels like we're a little bit closer to the solution. So. We did something, we did it correctly to both sides, so this equation must be the same like have the same solution as the original equation so we can keep going. And it seems like a good idea because it makes progress. What would you do next, Hunter?
Minus minus 2x plus 3x, which is 1x.
No.
Yes.
Why?
Well, let's see.
Yes.
We subtract 2x. First, let me address the divide.
No.
Yeah.
If I divide, this is going to make just as much of a mess as I just talked about.
You divide, buddy.
Divide by 2, you get x equals 3 halves x minus 8. Does that look better?
No.
Sure. Does it look more simple?
Yeah,
no.
It looks more simple.
Well,
it looks more simple in the sense that it was more simple.
No.
Well, especially with the fraction on the x, I would say, though it is true, I think that the person that might divide right now would probably do it incorrectly, and that's why they would, if they did it correctly and saw that they got x equals 3 halves x minus 8, that 3 halves x would just feel like hard to work with. Okay? Not that we can't, that we avoid things that are hard to work with, but I would say that there's something that we can do that's a little easier. And I would say there's even something that's easier than subtracting 2x. What would you do that would be?
That's what I was going to say.
What were you going to say? Subtract 2x?
Yeah.
Okay, let's subtract 2x. I'll show you why. Not wrong, but it is like one extra step, like a step more than we would need. So 2x minus 2x is 0. 3x minus 2x is x. Minus 16.
Well, there you go.
3x.
Does x equal negative 16? Because x minus 16 is on one side and 0 is on the other. 0
equals negative 16,
right?
No. Never mind.
Hunter?
Then you minus negative 3x from 3x, and then minus negative 3x from 2x.
So you're backing it up. Go back to here. 2x equals 3x minus 16. Subtract 3x. Subtract 3x. So it's 2x minus 3x.
Negative 1x
equals negative 16.
Not
divide by negative 1, and x is positive 16. What are we going to do to this equation that we give you the right solution?
Plus 16.
Plus 16. Plus 16 equals x. There's an infinite number of ways to, like, wait, series of steps that we could follow to get the same solution, okay? There are lots and lots and lots of them that are very, very complicated, okay? And there's a few of them that are not very complicated. The thing that's going to keep you from making these mistakes is an understanding of things like doing the same thing to both sides, combining like terms, okay? Especially when doing the same thing to both sides, remembering that if you divide, to divide everything on both sides by whatever you're dividing by. So just be careful about this, especially the dividing. I would just say, like, in your mind, think, should I divide right now? Well, if there's more than just a couple terms, I think I'm gonna wait. Especially if I see x in lots of different places, I'm just gonna wait. To divide by something if I see x in several different places. Okay. I would wait to divide until it looks like a number times x equals a number. Then I would divide. I would save it until then. You can do it beforehand, but it gets messier than you probably thought. So here's my recommendation. We're going to try another one. My recommendation is to cancel the variable on one side. This is my recommendation. It's not algebra law. It's just my recommendation that I would say cancel the constant, okay, on the side with, let's just call it x. The side with x, even though that x might be y or m or n or c or something like that. Now this is step 1 and 2. This is why I don't like step 1, step 2, step 3. Because there's never a step 1, there's hardly ever a step 1, 2, and 3 that works for everybody. Because if you'll notice, we did not follow these two steps when we solved this equation just now. Because my step one, personally for me, is to cancel the variable on one side. We did not do that. What did we do first?
We got to the
nine.
The nine, which is the constant. Does it work? Yes, it does. It did. It doesn't have to be that way. It doesn't have to be my way. That's why I like to leave it open. That requires you to think. Okay. So, if you want a couple of steps, oh, there they are. You can follow those. Let's throw another one up there. Like 5x plus 7 equals 3x minus 11. So, I'll show you my way. You don't have to do it my way, but I will show you my way, and I'll tell you why I do it this way. The first thing I do, rather than like subtract 7 or add 11, I look at the x's first. And I cancel the x's on one side in a way that leaves me with a positive x. Okay? Let me show you what I mean. If I subtract 5x from both sides, which I totally could do, what would that leave me with on this side?
Negative 2x.
I don't like negative x's. There's nothing wrong with them, I just don't prefer them, but if I subtract 3x from both sides, then what do I wind up with on the left side? That's why I do what I do first. I like to have a positive x. It's always possible, okay? You'll never have to have a negative. You can have a positive depending on how you do it. Even if I start with a negative x, maybe you need to subtract some from both sides or add to both sides, but one way is going to wind up with a positive x. And that's why I do what I do. Not because it's right, because it looks better to me. Alright. Have we made some progress? Mm-hmm. Why would you say that? Why would you say we made some progress? Jasper,
only got three
terms, not four. X is only in one place, not two places. It looks simple. Okay.
Oh.
What would we do next? Kelly?
Subtract 7.
I like it.
Thank you.
Because now we're not going to have anything other than x's on this side. And, well, that's good, because we want to get x by itself. It's enough said. We're going to have nothing but x's on this side. Negative 18 is where we are now. 2x equals negative 18. And now, and only now, would I divide. I would not divide any sooner than this in, like, 90% of cases. Divide by 2, x equals negative 18 divided by 2, negative 9.
Woo!
Plus a point for enthusiasm.
The bubble wants you, yeah, buddy.
By whatever on both sides can be done at any point, but it is really complicated if you do it sooner than towards the end. Wait till the end. Let's try this. Now, the step 1, 2, 3 thing is kind of out the window. Step 1 and step 2 that I gave you, you can't really start at step 1 right now. You gotta do something before that. There's even a couple of things that you could choose to do before you cancel out the variable on one side, if you're gonna follow my suggestion. Okay, so I'm gonna start with what you probably started with, and then I'm gonna show you how, you know, we don't always have to do the same thing, all of us, every time. Shrink this down, half page. You still see it?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay.
No.
No.
Yeah.
Okay. Well, there's one. Well, all right. So, did you start? Where'd you start?
Three.
Distribute the three. Yeah, I saw a lot of these arrows. Good job. 3 times 2x is 6x. 3 times 4 is 12. You're doing great.
That's 3. Okay.
Then I recommend.
Subtract.
What do you think, Hallie?
Subtract 3.
3x minus 3x. That's my suggestion. Because I get a positive x. Positive 3x.
12, 9,
back.
Then you subtract 9. 12.
Okay. Subtract 9. That's not what I would have done.
No.
12 minus 9 is 3. Equals 0.
What?
What's that?
Minus 3. I don't know what you do at that point.
Minus
3.
This
one is good. Minus 3 on both sides.
Oh, I did different.
Now, if you did minus 12 on both sides, this is where it would have taken you to negative 3 on the
right
side. So,
divide
by 3 Marcus says.
Miss.
Negative 1.
Ta-da.
Yes, we did it.
Oh, wait, you're not being even in a bad way. Okay, so let me show you what you could do instead, and actually probably what I would have done, but it's a little advanced. Okay. So the advanced algebraist. What do I have? 9 plus 3x? Is that right?
Yes.
Okay. Let's talk about the last step here. What was the last step we did?
Divide
by 3, because 3 divided by 3 is 1, right?
Yeah.
Okay, let me show you what I might do on this one. Take this side divided by 3, because 3 divided by 3 is 1. And both of these are divisible by 3. So I have 2x plus 4 equals 3 plus x. And then I would subtract x. X plus 4 equals 3. Subtract 4, and x equals negative 1.
Bro.
Oh, this is easy.
So instead of distributing the 3, I just divided the 3, canceled it before it ever needed to be distributed. Hunter?
What if you did instead of negative 4 minus negative 4, you did minus 3, so you would do minus 3 from 4, and that would be a positive 4.
Well, but that would, it would have a positive 1, but it would look like this, x plus 1 equals 0, and I don't know what x is. It doesn't look like x equals yet. Right? But if I subtract 1 from both sides, I get x equals negative 1.
Subtract 2x minus x, 1x.
Weird. 2x minus x, how is it 1x?
Yeah, you just got that.
2x minus 1x is...
Oh, 1x.
There. Another alternative. But distributing, it's reliable, okay? It feels safe. So go ahead and do it. But also, later on in your careers, in your algebra careers, dividing before you distribute becomes pretty helpful.
I'm going to do it that way.
Okay. So again, my recommendations would be, well, now, step... 0. Okay? Maybe distribute first. And then step 1, cancel the variable on one side. Cancel the constant. Maybe the last one. What would the last one be? Following along here.
Divide.
Divide. Divide, or maybe instead of, well, it's still the same as dividing, like multiply by reciprocal if there's a fraction on the x. And then this is the kind of thing where I don't really like step 1, 2, or 3, because either the steps have to be very vague as to be almost confusing, or very specific as to lock you into a box and stop you from thinking for yourself. Right? But if I'm going to make steps, they're always in the air on the side of being vague and open to changing these things. try that again. I mean, like, tomorrow we're going to try again on solving equations with variables on both sides. All right? Now we're going to go on to what if there's more than one kind of variable. More, like, not just x, or not just y, but there's an x and y. Start off slow. Let's start off even slower than that. X plus y equals 7. So now what I want you to do, I want you to solve for x. I mean, we'll just make it as introductory as possible. Solve for x, it just means, I mean, you don't have to tell me what a number x is. In fact, it's impossible to do that. But just get x by itself. Let's talk about this one. What would you do to get x by itself in this equation?
Minus 2.
Minus 2. Why would you minus 2?
Because
you want to get x by itself.
Because you want to get x by itself. That's it. That's all. Whatever it takes to get x by itself, that's what we're going to do, even if meddling with other variables. So in this case, x would be 5. In this case, we'll never know what x is until we know what y is. Okay. We're going to get x by itself. How can we get x by itself?
Minus y.
X equals 7 minus y. And that's as far as we can take it. X is by itself. We don't know what y is. But once we do, whenever that day comes, somebody tells us what y is, then I can tell you what x is. But until then, that's what it looks like. X equals 7 minus y.
Bless you.
Bless you.
Right. 2x plus y equals 4. This time, let's solve for y. It means to get y by itself. Have y be alone on one side. You think you got it?
Okay. So minus 2x by 4, and which equals y.
What's 2x minus 2x?
Zero.
0x. Is there anything left with the y on the left side?
No.
Y is by itself. 4 minus 2x, can it, is that 4 minus 2x, is that 2x or
negative
2x or 8x or
they're
not the same thing, they're apples and oranges, so we just leave them 4 minus 2x, that's what it looks like. We're done.
Yay.
Solve, one way to look at it means get y, get whatever the thing you're solving for by itself. Get that variable alone on one side. Solution, down to its very technical meaning, means the thing that you could plug in for that variable would make the equation true. If I plug this in for y, it'll be true, because it'll look like this. 2x plus y, which is 4 minus 2x,
whoa,
equals 4. Is it true? Well, what's 2x minus 2x?
0.
Is 4 equal to 4?
Yeah.
The equation is true, and this is what y equals.
Yeah.
It's kind of a circular logic kind of a thing, but it's true. Okay, now we should take the same equation and solve it for x. Solve for x. Okay, so like I said, if y was just some number, like if I plugged 3 in there for y or 7 or whatever, and then give you that equation, like 2x plus 7 equals 4, I don't think you'd have any trouble solving that. Right? What would you do? We won't even write it down. What would you do to solve this equation, Brandon?
Minus 2x, wait, or minus 7.
Minus 7, and then what would you do after that?
Minus 7 on the other side.
Right, and then after that?
2x
minus
2.
Solve it.
You do 2x
divided by
negative 3.
You cancel out the
divide. Yeah, you divide. So you subtract 7, then divide by 2. Subtract 7 by 2, right? So in this equation, we don't subtract 7 and divide by 2. We subtract what?
Y.
Subtract y. Y. X equals 4 minus y. And then what do we do?
Divide by 2.
X equals 4 minus y divided by 2. It doesn't look good. Looks like a mess.
No, sorry.
But those are the things you would need to do to get x by itself. You would need to subtract this constant, or what's kind of acting like a constant, away from both sides, so that it's no longer over here with 2x. We're going to divide by 2, so we have only 1x. So as I said, we have 1.3, that assignment that was up there for 1.3 that was due on Friday. I'm not going to enter that until tomorrow, so you still have till tomorrow to get that all done and turned in.
I don't remember if I did it.
I can check for you in just a second. And then 1.4, these four problems. 1.4 is stuff like this, where there's a few kinds of variables.
I'm gonna
get out of the way of everybody taking pictures and whatnot.